Hello, anatomy colleagues. This is Dr. Alsup, and in this session, we will be discussing the dural venous sinuses. And I hope you recall that dural venous sinuses are those endothelial lined spaces that form in specific areas where that meningeal dura will kind of reflect away from the periosteal dura. So if this is, say, periosteal dura, that meningeal dura will kind of reflect away from it, and you will have that deoxygenated blood kind of flowing through that region, heading back towards the heart. So similar to veins, but the composition of the walls of the dural venous sinuses are certainly different. These sinuses are making their way towards the internal jugular vein, which begins at the jugular foramen. So let's get started. And I want to note that there are many, many more venous sinuses than what we are going to discuss, and you need to be able to identify. But we're going to focus on the ones that I feel are the most easily observable, as well as the most clinically relevant of the dural venous sinuses. So we're going to start with the longest and typically easiest to identify, and this is the superior sagittal sinus, and you can see it here visible in this anterior superior view, kind of running right along this line here. It's going to be deep to this region, this kind of blue right here. You can also see the superior sagittal sinus in this view here, this more superior lateral view, and the brain has obviously been removed in this dissection, and it's running along the superior border of the fox cerebri. And I hope you recall that fox cerebri is a dural partition that is going to run between the two cerebral hemispheres. So it's running along the length here. It's easier to see in this particular dissection because it has been opened. So a portion of the dura has been removed in order to be able to see kind of the blood running within that region. And it will flow towards the confluence of sinuses, which is associated with the posterior portion of the skull, close to that occipital bone. So same image, but let's add in a couple of other sinuses. The inferior sagittal sinus is going to traverse the inferior concave free border of the fox cerebri. So it's kind of running in this general region right here. It's not clearly visible, as you can see with the superior sagittal sinus. You can see a little bit of blue right along this region here. So this would be about where that inferior sagittal sinus is running. You can see a lot of blue going on in this general region here. This is another sinus right here, but you can see that things are kind of collecting along this region here. And this is going to be where the confluence of sinuses is located. So this large area where multiple venous sinuses will drain. In fact, three sinuses in particular, that superior sagittal sinus, as well as the inferior sagittal sinus, will drain into the confluence, but the inferior sagittal sinus goes on a little bit more of a roundabout way. It drains into another sinus before reaching the confluence, whereas you can see that superior sagittal sinus is heading right towards that confluence. Now, looking at a superior view with the brain also removed here, but the tentorium cerebelli is still present. So one of those dural partitions of the tentorium cerebelli is located right here. The fox cerebri has been removed, even though you can see a little bit of where it was located here. And you can see the confluence of sinuses. You can see a bit of it right here. You can see a bit of it kind of extending in this region. And from there, the transverse sinuses will extend laterally from the confluence of sinuses. And we'll see a better view of the transverse sinuses in a moment in the next image. Moving anteriorly, we can begin to conceptualize the expansive cavernous sinuses. And these paired sinuses are lateral to the body of the sphenoid. Here's the body of the sphenoid. So the cavernous sinuses are going to extend from the superior orbital fissure all the way back towards the apex of the petrous part of the temporal bone. So this general area right here is going to be where the cavernous sinuses sit during life. You don't see a lot of the blue here. It's a little bit harder to see, but the cavernous sinuses are in those general regions. And as mentioned in the learning objectives, numerous neurovascular structures traverse either directly through the cavernous sinus or in the lateral walls of the sinus. And we'll actually dissect the cavernous sinus in an upcoming dissection where we'll remove the dura and we can actually see some of those neurovascular structures. All right, last image in the same superior view, but the difference here is that the tentorium cerebelli has been removed, so that kind of tent-like portion of the dural partition's been removed in order for us to be able to better view some of those deeper venous sinuses. And we've also opened up some of the sinuses to better view them as well. So here is the confluence of sinuses. It would actually extend a little bit in this direction as well if we remove some of the dura. And you can really see how the confluence is going to drain into the transverse sinuses that I'm outlining right here. I'm outlining the right transverse sinus. There will be a left transverse sinus as well, but the dura has not been removed in this portion in order to view that a little bit better. And it is at the level, or right where we reach that petrous part of the temporal bone, which kind of extends back into this region, that we're going to have the name change to the sigmoid sinus. So right about right here, where you get that sharp turn, sharp inferior turn, the name changes from transverse sinus to sigmoid sinus. And the sigmoid sinuses, after picking up a smaller sinus along the way, will head towards the jugular foramen, which is in this general region right here. And it is at the jugular foramen that the internal jugular vein begins and will traverse the neck. And you can even see some of the cranial nerves heading towards the jugular foramen here. All right, that was a lot of dural venous sinus fun. I am so happy we got to spend some time working through how to locate these, or at least begin to conceptualize where they would be located. Please do take time to review and try to identify the sinuses on your own. And as always, please feel free to reach out to me with any questions. I thank you for your time and attention.